Meanwhile, the recent move by the federal government to pay 5,000 naira to 40 million Nigerians as transportation allowance to cushion the effect of fuel subsidy removal has started to generate reactions among Nigerians. Ivan TV senior reporter Ayiboje Ukoria reports that most respondents in Lagos State are against the decision.
It started with the Chairman Senate Committee on Finance, Solomon Adeola, who said there is no provision for the monthly 5,000 naira transport grant for 40 million poor Nigerians in the 2022 budget currently being considered by the National Assembly.
Some quarters says the Honorable Minister of Finance budget and was quoted saying that 40 million Nigeria will be paid 5,000 naira as transportation allowance in lieu of the fuel subsidy. I don't want to go into these details for now. I believe that if such proposal is to come to pass, a document to that effect must be sent to the National Assembly for us to see how possible, how visible if this is, and how do we identify these 40 million Nigeria that are going to benefit from this process.
The situation is also not different on the streets of Lagos, where most Nigerians already see the policy as anti-people and said they don't believe in it.
I don't really see that as going to be helpful to Nigerians. The best thing is let them forget about the 5,000, because even when you decide that you want to give it out, they might end up channeling it to the wrong people.
In actual reality, whichever of the two decisions decide to take, none of them is going to be favorable to us, in the sense that the subsidy itself is actually a means of scamming Nigerians. A station where we have to drill oil here, go outside, export it outside to go and refine, bring it back here, incurring costs, taking it down there and bringing it back, and now putting the money on the federal government to pay a subsidy is a scam. Why can't we turn around our refineries? So that's why I said, if the subsidy, if he says it is a scam, if it goes and they now say they want to start giving us 5,000, it's still a bad policy. Why will you spend, for instance, 100 billion naira simply to take away the pain of 20 billion naira? It doesn't make sense.
It actually causes inflation, because reacting to that, people will begin to increase prices of stuff to meet up with the subsidy and all of that. The government have not really been helping the nations. I think everybody need to focus on their self, what they can do for their self against that, because if you watch recently, the prices of things over time, they keep multiplying.
An economist and a non-executive director of CBN, Professor Mike Obada, said the decision is in the right direction if only government has the mechanism to check its adverse effect on inflation.
The removal may have a net impact, on inflation. And if that one happens, that in itself, may also make the monetary policy of the central bank more challenging.
If the federal government insists on removing subsidy from petroleum products mid-2022, there are speculations that a liter of fuel will be between 350 to 400 naira. Ayiboje Ukoria reporting.